to our respected management members, our principal ma'am, Dr. Juhi Samarpita, and my friends. Today, 8 May, we all assemble here to celebrate the World Red Cross Day. This day is observed on May 8 on the occasion of birthday of Henry Dunant, the founder of International Red Cross Society. On this day, we should take an oath to support the functioning of Indian Red Cross Society. So, with me, Arpita, let us start today's program. First, I would like to invite Deepika Jha to deliver a short speech on Red Cross Society.
Good day, everyone. Today, we are celebrating World Red Cross Day. This day, 8th of May, is marked to celebrate as Red Cross Day, as it's the birthday of Mr. Dunant Henry, the founder of Red Cross Committee International in 1863 at Switzerland, Geneva. As we all are aware that Red Cross Society has been playing a very important role in the service of mankind. World Red Cross Society is helping people who are suffering from food shortage, calamities, war, as well as epidemics. Red Cross Society provides its service to needy people all around the world, be it food, medicine, shelter, whatever is required for their well-being. Various people from different sections of society, be it governmental or private organizations, are active members of Red Cross Society. There are about 97 lakh people, members and volunteers associated with Red Cross Society all over the world. They are honored to do every task, be it in providing health, food, hygiene, sanitization, women health issues, and many other type of relief work. Approximately 240 lakh people around the world have been helped by the workers of Red Cross in one way or other.
Thank you, Deepika. Now I would like to call my few friends to say few slogans on Red Cross Day.
Good afternoon, everyone. On the occasion of World Red Cross Day, let us join hands to make everyone in this world healthier and happier. Happy World Red Cross Day. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is the duty of every human to serve humanity, and we must always do so to extend our contribution towards Red Cross. Happy World Red Cross Day.
Thank you all. Now Dimpi is coming to explain the meaning of Red Cross emblem.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Dimpi Kumari, and here I am to explain you about the meaning of emblem of Red Cross. Before I start telling you the meaning of emblem of Red Cross, let me tell you something about this organization. This was an organization which was established by Henry Dunant on 9th February 1863 in Geneva of Switzerland by forming a committee of 5 people. He named this organization as an International Committee for Relief to the Wounded. Then there was an international conference held in Geneva in which 18 countries took part in this organization. After which the Red Cross was legally recognized. So the emblem of Red Cross with arms of equal length, see, with the arms of equal length on a white background is the visible sign of protection under 1949 Geneva Conventions. As such, it is the emblem of Armed Forces Medical Services. The Red Cross logo was designed by Henry Dunant in 1863. The Red Cross Day is also known as Red Crescent Day. Then, this organization was the first to open the blood bank in America in 1937. This organization helps the people suffering from anemia, cancer, AIDS, etc. Thank you.
Thank you, Dimpy, for making everyone aware of Red Cross emblem. Now I would like to invite Pinky Sharma to deliver a short poem on this occasion.
Good afternoon. Today we are celebrating Red Cross Day. So I, Pinky Sharma, going to recitate a poem. I was 7 years old when began World War II, and 11 became by the time it was through. Since there was no TV, it was a newsreel alone, where real pictures of overseas combat were shown. I was there with the elder children and moms, watching B-25 on their target drop bombs, and on living room radios, nightly we had here latest news of the war, and if good, we would cheer. In the Junior Red Cross, we made present to send to men who had gone to our country defend. We had city-wide blackouts where curtain were drawn, and a Victoria Garden where used to be lawn. Some things rationed were gasoline, sugar, and meat, so we drove our class less, and strange dishes we had eat. I can also remember how much mother cried when the radio said Franklin Roosevelt died. Our lives and homes were the same as before. A hard war had been fought and the good guys had won. Thank you.
Present here, I, Nishi, on behalf of my friends, would like to thank management members, respected principal ma'am and teachers who gave us this opportunity to celebrate this auspicious day. I thank all my friends without whose participation in this program cannot be presented. I'd like to thank all my supporting staff of our institution for their supporting and cooperation. Thank you.